Hello, everybody. Today I wanted to do something a little different. I wanted to speak with you about one of my life experiences working for the railroad. As many of you know, based on my YouTube channel and the train videos that undoubtedly brought many of you to the channel and to subscribe, to that I thank you. As you can tell, I've been a train enthusiast for most of my life, and from about 2008, 2009, when the economy tanked, I decided that I wanted to work for the railroad. It seemed like a logical step. It was something I was interested in. It was something that is financially lucrative, not lucrative, but financially stable, good benefits, good retirement. And so I set about trying to make that a reality, and it wound up taking 8 full years. It took up to 2009 to 2017, so this whole thing transpired about a year ago. I applied for a conductor trainee position with the Portland and Western Railroad, and much to my surprise, after years of rejection and even I think it was 2 failed interviews prior to that. It was 2 failed interviews prior to that. It was a surreal thing, and it never actually wound up feeling real. So I was offered the job on, let me see here, I believe it was May. I'll recognize the date if I see it. I believe it was May 30th of 2017. Yeah, it would have been Tuesday, May 30th. My last day at my old job was June 16th, and then it was a Friday. Then the training began the following Monday. For how things ended, they started out extraordinarily well. We began 2 weeks of in-class training. There were supposed to be 12 of us, there were 11. Not sure I'm at liberty to say why number 12 wasn't there, but needless to say, he lied about something and they caught him, so his offer was rescinded. But anyway, we went through everything. We went through the safety aspect, we went through couplers and signals and hazmat and you name it, we went through it. We had several days out in the field changing coupler knuckles, getting on and off equipment, walking the length of a train, everything like that. And while I was in it, I thought, this is awesome. This is my dream. And it's finally coming true. Unfortunately, as things often do in a connected world, I was outed, I guess you could say. Despite my best efforts to keep my railfan status a secret, it was out within 36 hours, I think. But I didn't let it stop me. So we continued, and I passed the class with, I think my class average was 93 or 94%. It was somewhere up there. And I should preface this by saying that I have never been a strong test taker. I can know the material, but you put a test in front of me and I'm not very good at it. So that was really quite an achievement for me. But little did I know, it would kind of lay the foundation for this endeavor's eventual failure. So after the 2 weeks of training, I went in on, I think it was Monday the 3rd. Because it was 4th of July. I think 4th of July fell on a Tuesday that year. So, went out on Monday, did the last bit of paperwork. Excuse me. Got my lantern, keys, radio, and a whole bunch of other stuff that we needed for the job. And then I reported for my first day as a trainee conductor that Wednesday. So it would have been Wednesday, July 5th, 2017. And for the first week and a half, I was nervous, but I was excited, and I was very willing to to learn. I wanted to do well. I even told my dad, I said, if I'm lucky, this will be the last job I ever apply for. And turned out that was not the case. Week two, first full week, I was put on a job the second half of the week, and it was really a wake-up call. Did not get along well with the two people who I was with, and that was at the point where I began to think to myself, what am I doing here? Began to realize there is a hobby, and then there is something that you can enjoy as work. But with exceptions, those two things that you can't, they can't mix. And it was by the end of the second week that I realized that this was not for me. And it was a tough pill to swallow. It really was. And I was in denial at first. I thought, no, this can't be. I'll just take the weekend off and I'll come back on Monday and things will be fine. But they weren't. They would never be fine. The straw that broke the camel's back was I was uninformed of a change in report time for one of my night shifts, and a friend who works at my old job, now my current job, mentioned to our boss that I wasn't happy and that I was thinking about coming back, and I told him that, but I don't know if I told him that to kind of make myself feel better, to make me believe that I had an out, but I think he saw how true it was, even if I didn't. So they called me and they said, well, do you want to come back? I said, let me think about it. And that was on a Tuesday. And the report time change event occurred on a Thursday. And it took me 2 hours, 2 full hours, to get in touch with somebody, a manager. Finally got in touch with a manager who was on vacation. He was nice enough to call me back. And I was like, well, I'm here. I was supposed to be here at 8 o'clock. And he said, oh, report time was changed to 7. Didn't anybody tell you? It was no, nobody told me anything. So the next day I called my boss first thing in the morning because I was working nights for the railroad at that point, and I said, do you guys have me back? And can I get my old pay level back? And he said yes. And so I wrote my resignation letter that afternoon, and that was that. I don't put this together to frighten people who might be fans of trains. I'm telling you this to give you a realistic expectation of what the job is. And the job is extremely physical, it's extremely demanding, and it's very tiring. You're talking 12 hours on, 12 hours off, and then back for another 12. It is go, go, go. If you're not working, you're sleeping. It's that simple. If you want any semblance of a social life, you have to figure out how much sleep you can do without, safely. And I went into this knowing this was not a game. I have an immense amount of respect for the people who do this job. They do it safely and they do it properly and they do it every single day. But there are things that you can't quantify based on observation. There are some things you simply have to witness and be a part of and be involved in order to truly understand what it is and what it takes to succeed. Now, that's not to say somebody who is an enthusiast in trains can't survive. I know of a couple people who have, but it is the exception by a long shot rather than the rule. I'll, and to put it into words that one of the coworkers I did not get along with well at all. He said this to me, and it's even though I don't like him, I think he's an asshole. It's true. If you just want to ride a train, get on Amtrak. Don't work for the railroad. And I agree with him 100%. Doesn't change the fact that we didn't get along. Doesn't change the fact that I don't like him. But I agree with him on this point. It's, as I said, it's extremely physically demanding. You're walking all the time outside, searing heat, blowing rain, ice, snow, hot, cold, you name it. The evenings where it was 72 degrees and perfectly clear as the sun went down, I was riding the back of a grain hopper. That was the dream right there. But it took two very seasoned individuals with a very real perspective to show me what I needed to see. And I don't begrudge them a bit for it. In fact, they saved me. They realized I didn't belong there before I did. And I don't regret trying it, and I don't regret leaving it. It was a life experience, and those are few and far between, and we have to take them and we have to extract something from them. So, if this has not in any way swayed you, you are still... Because people told me this. They told me exactly what I'm telling you, and I didn't listen. Because I thought I knew better. And I can't speak to your situation, whatever that might be. But if you might be the one who can balance the hobby with the job. But the thing is, for me, the job ruined the hobby. That's why you don't see train videos from me anymore. It's because that X factor that I enjoyed so much is gone. I know enough about it that it's not novel, it's not exciting, it's not romantic, for lack of a better term. It's just something I did, and it's something I'm not interested in anymore. You'll occasionally see stuff from me, but for the most part, I've moved on from my life in trains. And the other thing that was important in this shift that eventually led me going back to school was because that second week I was sitting there going, why am I here? I did so well on these tests. What other things could I do well at? And so that was my epiphany, my aha moment, as it were. It was, well, this didn't work. I'll try something else. So I just wanted to kind of, this idea came to me when I was at work the other day, and I thought it'd be kind of fun to put together. I'm just kind of spitballing here. I don't have a script in front of me or anything. I'm just kind of saying these things as they come. So, if you are pursuing a career in the railroad, do your research, do your homework. It's not all roses. Far and away, it's not all roses. It is a very hard, very demanding job. There's a lot of walking. As I said, there's a lot of climbing on and off. Lots of loud noises. Your hearing is going to take a real beating. But for that, on the flip side, you get compensated handsomely for your time. And as long as you keep your wits about you, keep your head on your shoulders, you can survive this job. But if you don't, this stuff will kill you. It will kill you without mercy, and it will kill you immediately. It's heavy metal. It's not a toy. That's the God's truth. If you guys have any questions that I haven't covered here, I did my best to try to touch base on everything. Please don't hesitate to let me know. And I will do my best to answer in the comments. And I hope everybody has a wonderful fall and into next year. Take care.